All right, welcome back everybody for our second module in the Fiddleheads mini workshop. Today we're gonna, this module, we're gonna start talking fern, by which I mean learning some of the weird vocabulary associated with ferns, specifically for the vegetative parts of ferns. And I've mentioned already in the previous module how sort of distinct ferns are evolutionarily. And of course, that means that they're often studied by a different group of specialists, and they develop their own terminology. But they also are not that distantly related to flowering plants. And many of the terms that we use for flowering plants can equally well be applied to ferns. And so we often, for example, call fern leaves fronds, but a frond is a leaf. And so you can just call it a leaf if you want. And so working through some of this terminology, we'll start from the bottom and go up here. So H, as I just mentioned, this thing here that we see so often, this frond is a leaf. Frond or leaf is perfectly fine. A fern leaf often has a portion of it that is expanded, which we call a blade. And then it has a portion of it that in angiosperms, we would call a petiole, a little stalk. You can call that a petiole, or sometimes in ferns, we call that a stipe, the same thing, petiole, stipe, blade. And then a blade is divided often into different leaflets. A leaf is divided into leaflets. Excuse me. In ferns, we call those things pinna. So each of these little things would be a pinna, but basically it's a leaflet. And ferns, of course, also have stems. Those stems are often creeping along the ground or under the ground, but we almost never call them stems. We call them rhizomes, but it's the same thing. A fern stem is called a rhizome. A fern leaf may be called a frond. But these are all very similar. They're all the same thing, basically. And so one shouldn't feel any pressure to use this specialized terminology. You could just call them leaves and petioles and stems. There are a few things in ferns that are unique, one of which is most fern leaves develop in this very particular fiddlehead way, which we call a crozier. So that's a specialized term. That's a good one to be familiar with. And of course, the way that fern leaves often are structured, the way they're shaped, often involves a sort of regular repeat of different units. They have this very sort of geometric look to them, which means that we have a bit of a specialized vocabulary to describe that. And so here, for example, we're looking at a leaflet. So in ferns, we often call leaflets pinna. That's the same thing. One leaflet is a pinna. Leaflets are pinna, pinna versus pinnae, I guess. And then you could have a division of a leaflet, like a leafletlet, which we call a pinule. So again, very straightforward concepts, but sometimes a bit confusing because they have specific terms associated with them. There's also a whole bunch of terms associated with orientation of things or position of things. We might say that something is pointing upwards, acroscopic, versus pointing downwards, basiscopic. We might say something is near the bottom, proximal, versus near the top, distal. Or we might say something is on the bottom surface, abaxial, or on the top surface, adaxial. And these two words are ridiculously similar, of course. And so I usually remember that abaxial means bottom. Did I cut out for anybody? I'm gonna hope not. I froze for myself, but I hope that didn't happen to anybody else.
I can hear you. Everything's good.
Okay, great. One other term that's very useful to remember that I should have mentioned actually and the first time, the main axis of the blade is called a rachis. The main axis of a leaflet is called a costa. And the secondary axes would be called costules. So rachis is the main sort of central axis of the blade of a leaf. Leaves are divided up in various ways and various degrees of dissection. Some leaves aren't divided at all. We call them simple. Some leaves are divided more than halfway, but not all the way to the midrib. We call those panatophid. And then some leaves are divided all the way to the midrib. We call those pinnate. And then you can imagine if the leaflets themselves are divided like this, then you would have something that's twice pinnate, et cetera. And so here's an example of a thrice pinnate, a tripinnate leaf. So here's the whole leaf. Well, here's the blade of it, I should say. you imagine you could divide it like this in this dimension, and you'd get one of these units, which is a leaflet. So that's a pinna. You divide that leaflet up with a second cut, you'll get these leafletlets, whatever, a pinule. And then you divide that pinule up a third time, and you'll get these ultimate segments here. So it takes three different cuts to make this leaf. It's a three divided leaf, tripinnate or thrice pinnate leaf. Here's an example of a once pinnate leaf. So it's just been one cut to give you each of these leaflets, and then those leaflets themselves are not further divided. Here's an example of an entire leaf, no cutting at all. This is an asplenium species. This is a plisticum from Eastern North America. Here you have an example where it's cut once, but not quite all the way. So very close, but not quite. So this is a panata leaf. Here's another highly divided leaf. So one cut this way, once, twice this way to give us one of these units. And they themselves are cut, but not quite all the way. So this is two pinnate panata, two full cuts, one partial cut. Two pinnate panata. And finally, this one's a very useful one to know because it's quite common in one particular group of ferns. This is cut all the way once, and then those leaflets are themselves cut, but not all the way. So this is pinnate panata. Pinnate panata leaves are very, very common in the marsh fern family. We'll talk about that a little bit later. Leaf margins have their own terms. I'm not going to read all these out. They are very similar to the ones that you would use for angiosperms, and you could always look them up. They are very useful, though, of course, there's a lot of them are very similar to each other. And finally, leaf shapes or leaflet shapes are also very helpful to be able to describe. One particularly useful fern one is what's called dimidiate, this one in the middle. And that's where the leaf is strongly asymmetrical. The vein, the middle vein, the mid vein is very close to one edge of the leaf or the leaflet as opposed to the other edge, dimidiate. And so if you're walking in the forest, you found a fern, you forgot your field guide, but you want to be able to key this fern out later, what sorts of features should you note? So first of all, cutting of the leaf. How many times cut is it? This one is once and a bit. This is a pinnate panatifid leaf. The leaf shape, okay, it tapers relatively abruptly to the top, parallel sided, and then ends abruptly at the bottom. Leaflet and ultimate segment shape. So are there sharp teeth on the segments? Are they kind of blunt? Are they pointy? Things like that. Indument, are there any scales or hairs on the leaves? These ones don't appear to have any, although they do have on the petiole a lot of scales. The petiole itself, how long is it? Is it a particular color? These are pretty long, light colored petioles. And then the rhizome, the stem, what shape is it? Is it upright, like in this case, or is it a long creeping rhizome? How are the leaves arranged on the rhizome, et cetera? And does that rhizome have its own hairs or its own scales? And so if you note those features, even just sort of unconsciously, you're in a very good shape to be able to identify most ferns just based on those vegetative features alone.